We have previously learned about what an ANOVA is and what it does. If you don't know, go watch my video about it. I have linked it in the description. I'll wait. Alright, so here's the deal. ANOVA assumes that the data is normally distributed. That means that technically you're only allowed to perform ANOVA when the data actually is normally distributed. The problem is we can only find out after the analysis by looking at a QQ plot. Hey, my name is Marcel, I have a PhD in chemical engineering, and this video is about QQ plots, normally distributed data, how normally distributed data looks like in a QQ plot, and what to do with your ANOVA when your data is not normally distributed. So what was a normal distribution again? A normal distribution is just a way of describing how your data tends to scatter around its mean. It's this famous bell-shaped curve you've probably seen a million times, but if not, no problem. If you measure something like the yield of a chemical reaction over and over, most of the results will be close to the average of these measurements. Fewer will be a little further away, and only a couple will be way off from the average value. And if you measure that like a million times, you will get a beautiful symmetric bell-shaped curve, with 68% of all your measurements being within one standard deviation apart from the mean, and 95% of your measurements being within two standard deviations away from the mean. Well, as long as your data is normally distributed. The problem now is that it's pretty difficult to see just from the shape of the curve whether or not your data is normally distributed, and that's where the QQ plot comes in. It's a super handy visual tool to see if your data fits a theoretical distribution like the normal distribution. You plot the quantiles of your data against the quantiles of its theoretical distribution, and if everything is behaving as it should, those points are going to fall in line. Literally, they'll form a straight line on the plot. Now, what are quantiles again, you might ask? Let's break down quantiles real quick. Because these just divide your data into equal parts. The median, for example, is a quantile. It's the middle value where half your data is below and half is above. Then you've also got quartiles, which break your data into four parts, and percentiles, which break them into 100 parts. And all of those are quantiles. Quantile is just the overarching term. And since it's relatively easy to calculate the quantiles for both the theoretical distribution as well as your own data, we use the QQ plot to check whether or not your own data aligns with what we'd expect from a normal distribution or normal distributed data. Oh, and if you didn't figure it out yourself already, the QQ in QQ plot stands for quantile quantile. So it's a quantile quantile plot. Now, the ideal case for a QQ plot is a straight line at a 45 degree angle. But in practice, it's completely fine if there's some deviation from that line. Just certain trends like S-shape or curves are bad. So what can you do when your data shows a trend like an S-shape or a curve in the QQ plot instead of a straight line? First, data transformation. You go back to your measurements and try a logarithmic or square root transformation, and sometimes that's all you need. Second, maybe you excluded an interaction that was borderline significant. Take them back in. Or maybe you have forgotten a key interaction. Go and check your model. And third, if your data allows it, try to fit a quadratic model instead of a linear one. And if none of these options work, then ANOVA might not be the right tool for you and you need to try different statistical methods. Let me know in the comments if that's something you'd be interested in. But hey, fingers crossed that ANOVA does the trick for you. Like and subscribe for more content about DOE.